Hiya, today in this video we are going to discuss the still coupling reaction and still carbonylative coupling reaction. We are going to see its reaction and its mechanism and going to see some examples from literature. Let's begin. Still reaction. In still reaction, the alkyl halide is treated with a tin compound in presence of a catalyst, which is palladium zero catalyst. Forms the coupled product. The still reaction is a chemical reaction which is widely used in organic synthesis. It involves two organic groups. One is called as organotin compound and another one is the coupling partner, which may be of sp2 hybridized carbon, which may be allyl, alkenyl or aryl. And this halide, this X may be halides, pseudo halides like OTF. In presence of a palladium, the coupling happens. This is called a still coupling reaction. This is the mechanism of still coupling. Here, the palladium zero complex is present here. First step is the oxidative addition. Here, the alkyl halide is used. Alkyl halide or OTF also used in presence of X. With weaker ligands such as ASPH3, the transmetallation is enhanced. This process is enhanced. While in the step of oxidative addition, the X, which is the leaving group, and this R will add at the transposition, and the ligands will be also in the transposition. The next step is the transmetallation. In transmetallation, this X and this tin organotin compound is eliminated, forming this palladium intermediate. Here in presence of X, the X is replaced by R dash here, which is attached to the tin compound. After that transmetallation, the cis trans isomerization happens. Here these two ligands are in trans position and it will come into the cis position. And after that, the reductive elimination happens, forming the coupled product. Thus, the mechanism can be explained. When X is the TF, which is tiflate, lithium chloride is often needed as an additive. It's a note. This is an example which is taken from organic letters paper. Here, the starting material is treated with organotin compound in presence of palladium zero complex, and here the copper co-catalyst is added as in the Sonnegaux-Schiele coupling. But this is the still coupling reaction because we are using here as a tin organotin compound, forming the coupled product. Let's see the mechanism. This is the oxidative addition. The palladium is added with the I, which is a leaving group, is attached here. And the ligands are in trans position. Here the ligand is PHCN twice. This ligands are in trans position and this R group is attached in the trans position of iodine. Next step is the transmetallation. The transmetallation, the iodine and this tin group is eliminated and it is replaced by this group. This group is replaced in presence of SnBu3. After that, cis trans isomerization happens. Here you see these two ligands are in trans position. It will come under the cis position. Then the reductive elimination happens. The reductive elimination, these two ligands are eliminated and these two compounds are coupled together and palladium is regenerated. This palladium is regenerated and this coupled product is formed. Here NMP means N-methyl-2-pyrrolidine and BMIM-BF4 is 1-butyl-3-methyl-imidazonium-tetrafluoroborate. This is the another example which is taken from JAX. This is a starting material. We are treating with organotin compound, forming this coupled product. The first step is the oxidative addition. The oxidative addition, the palladium is added with the two ligands which are in transposition, and this bulky group, this huge compound is added here, and this bromine is added here, which are in transposition. After that, transmetallation happens. In transmetallation, bromine is replaced with this group. After that, cis trans isomerization happens. In cis trans isomerization, the two ligands will come under the cis position, and this group and this thin compound here, the BuS3SN, this one and bromine will be eliminated in transmetallation. After that, cis trans isomerization happens. The cis trans isomerization, this group also come under the cis position. After that, reductive elimination happens, forming this couple product. Let's next is the still carbonylative coupling. The still carbonylative coupling is similar to the still coupling reaction. In this reaction, the RX, which is an alkyl halide, this R may be sp2 hybridized, which may be alkyl, alkenyl or aryl, vinyl also used. This R dash is also sp2 hybridized carbon, and this X may be halides, pseudo halides, OTF, etc. In presence of palladium and carbon monoxide is added, forming this couple product, and carbonyl group is also added here. This is the mechanism of still carbonylative coupling. Here the palladium zero complex is here. The first step is similar to the still coupling, which is oxidative addition. Here the two ligands are in cis trans position, and the here X is the leaving group, R is the alkyl group, which here it is added in trans position. After that step, carbon monoxide insertion. Here the C double bond O is inserted here. Then the next step is transmetallation. The transmetallation, this tin group and this leaving group is eliminated, and this R dash is added here. Next is the cis trans isomerization. In the cis trans isomerization, these two ligands in trans position will come into the cis position. After that, the reductive elimination happens. See, this is the taken example which is taken from literature, Chemical Society Reviews 2011. Here, this is the starting material. We are reacting with the tin orno-tin group. Whenever you see the orno-tin group and this alkyl halide, this is the still, you see here carbon monoxide is here, so it is still carbonylative coupling. This here the palladium zero complex is there, and carbon monoxide is given, and orno-tin group is given, so it is still carbonylative coupling. After this, it forms the couple product, and C double bond O is inserted, and R dash is there. The first step is the oxidative addition. Here the palladium, we are adding two ligands are there, and we are adding this leaving group OTF and this R group, which are in trans position. The next step is the CO insertion, carbon monoxide insertion. Here the carbon monoxide is inserted here, and this group is there, and after the transmetallation happens. In the transmetallation, this group and this tin group is eliminated, forming this complex, which is an intermediate, palladium intermediate. Here R dash is added here. The next step is the cis trans isomerization. Here the two ligands are in trans position, will come under the cis position. The next step is the reductive elimination. The reductive elimination, these two ligands are eliminated and this two are coupled and palladium is regenerated, forming this product. This is another example which is taken from JAX. You see, this is the starting material. We are treating with organotin compound. This is organotin and this is the alkyl halide. Here the carbon monoxide is there and palladium zero catalyst is there. Then it is the still carbonylative coupling reaction. Here the steps involved is oxidative addition. The next step is CO insertion and the next transmetallation and cis trans isomerization and reductive elimination. These steps are involved in this reaction. Instead of doing these steps, the simple trick is you remove this Me3SN and remove this iodine with bond. What you have to do is you bring this product here. After removing this, you add C double bond O because we have to add carbon monoxide here, so the carbonylative coupling happens. So we are adding C double bond O group here. After the C double bond O group, you bring this group to here and this is the product. See, this is the product, coupled product. See, these are some of the references for further reading. You can read this book, Smith by March, Advanced Organic Chemistry, and this journal for further reading if you are interested. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. If you like this channel, please like this, share to your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe to get notified.